Hey everybody, welcome to the channel. Today we're making spicy chicken lentil and veggie soup with leeks and cilantro and yellow squash. Got some yellow onion, some garlic. Let's get started. We use chicken leg quarters, organic chicken broth, leeks and cilantro, yellow squash, yellow onion, garlic. Also use an already cooked jasmine rice, uncooked lentils, crushed red pepper, cumin, oregano leaves, Weber Korean barbecue seasoning. First, we're gonna make our chicken stock. We use all the stems. We're gonna use our onion peels and all the leek greens. Put those in a pot with our chicken when we make our chicken stock. So we set them all in a bowl. We don't use the roots from the leeks because those usually have dirt. So we're gonna toss those aside. And like I said, we use the lighter green and the white for the soup. But the green part, we'll chop that up, as you'll see, and that gets thrown in with chicken stock. Making sure to wash those leeks really good so there's no dirt. Season our chicken with their Korean barbecue seasoning. Got four leg quarters. It's just right for this recipe. Adding in our onion peels, garlic cloves, leek greens, and cilantro stems. Just throw it all in there. 32 ounces of chicken stock. This is gonna be our base for the soup. Go for about 40 minutes on our chicken. While that's cooking, we're gonna chop up our cilantro. We're gonna chop up our other vegetables, and we keep them separate because they go in at different times. You don't wanna just throw it all in together or it'll be a big bunch of mush, which we don't want. So our leeks and our onions take a little longer to cook, so we'll put those in one bowl. There's our leek stock, mostly just the white part. We use those greens for that stock that's cooking right now. It smells really good. So chop up our leeks. Yummy, yummy. And the yellow squash, we're gonna cut those up into bite-sized pieces. Now, we don't want to cut them too small because they don't take hardly any time at all to cook. And they'll turn to mush if you put them in too soon or if you cut them too small. Nice bite-sized pieces. And there we go. Now, once we've gotten to this point, we rinse our lentils, put them in a bowl. We have our lentils, our onions. When the chicken's done, make sure to get all as much of the chicken out as you can. It's falling apart, so just take that out using your spoon. There's our delicious chicken. It's falling apart. Just about 40 minutes with your pressure cooker on high. There's other ways to do it, but this is what tastes the best. Now, we're gonna drain off our stock through a strainer. And the meat's cooking off to the side. What we do is kind of pick through, get our nice garlic cloves. The reason we run it through a strainer is to make sure we don't get any bones or unwanted onion skins and stuff like that. So pick through, get the stuff you like. Everything else just goes off to the side in the compost. Now in our soup pan, we're gonna put a little bit of olive oil. Now we're gonna add the leeks and the onions. Get those covered with oil. little bit of salt and pepper. Gotta make sure salt and pepper those. It gets those nice and flavorful before you add your stock. Dump in your chicken stock. Starting to look like a soup. We're gonna add another 32 ounces of chicken stock just to go with that. At this point, we put in our uncooked lentils that we rinsed and sorted. Now, if you don't have cooked rice, this is where you would add your rice as well. Maybe a cup. But my rice is already cooked. So we're gonna go 30 minutes, let that cook on a medium heat while we debone the chicken. Being very careful not to leave any bones, because nobody wants bones in their soup. What do you guys think so far? Thank you. Thank you very much. Starting to look like a soup. So it takes a little time to debone the chicken, but it's worth it. And you'll know why once you taste it. So, once you've got all of your chicken deboned, you're ready for the next step. Stir it up a little, make sure your lentils are soft. Add in your chicken. Crushed red pepper, I like a lot. Your ground cumin and oregano leaves. Add in however much you like. You could always add more later. Yellow squash. Oh yeah, cilantro. Don't want to stir it up too much. Just kind of tap it in on the top. Let it sit at medium for about 15 minutes. But before that, add your cooked rice. Now you let it sit for about 15 minutes. And there you go. Ready to go. So delicious on a cold winter day. Looks great, tastes great. Your friends are gonna love you. Please like and subscribe and share this video if you like what you see. As always, thank you for watching. This is a great meal that you can put in containers, put it in the fridge. It's good for 5 to 7 days. You could freeze it, and when you throw it in a pan on a cold winter day, you're gonna love it. Thanks again for watching, folks, and we'll see you on the next one.